Hey everyone, if you've ever invested in a NAS but then you've been too busy to explore its full potential, you might be missing out on a lot. That's because a proper NAS from a company like QNAP or Synology doesn't just allow you to easily manage your files. In this video, I cover 10 other pretty cool things you can use a NAS for. These also make for great talking points when you're on a date too. Kidding. By the way, if you see me point over there all the time in this video when I say NAS, it's because my Synology NAS lives down there, so I'm not just pointing at some random area of my house like a madman. Anywho, the first use for a NAS is as a local gaming server. While this is sort of possible with Synology, QNAP actually lists this as a specific selling point for some of their more powerful models. Their initial suggestion is that you can store all of your Steam games, for example, within the NAS itself, and then mount these as folders on your PC for use as your Steam library install location. This could work fairly well, although naturally you'd only really want to do this with their 2.5 gig Ethernet models and also using SSDs, not hard drives. Otherwise, games wouldn't be streamed fast enough from your NAS to your computer. You can actually kick this up a notch though, because some QNAP models actually support GPU pass-through, meaning that you could in theory install a PCI Express GPU and then render the games directly from your NAS, streaming the output to your PC. This can work, and I know a few people who do this, but it does require lots of tinkering, so at this point, probably building a specific gaming PC might just be easier and cheaper. The second thing you can do is turn your NAS into a CCTV surveillance center. This is what I actually do. Many Synology NASs come with a free two-camera license for the Synology surveillance station, meaning you can install and power up to two cameras for free before you then need to pay. I'll cover this point more in a second. But the way that the surveillance station works is that you install your cameras as normal, but instead of then downloading loads of different apps on your phone to manage all these different cameras, you can instead add them to the surveillance station control panel. You can then use Synology to control and configure them, and Synology will take care of everything from the recording resolution and FPS to the recording frequency. I currently have 4 Power over Ethernet cameras installed around my property, and Synology records footage from these 24/7 and stores them directly on my NAS. I can then access the recordings on my PC, on my phone through Synology's own app, or I can access the direct MP4 recordings via a file browser, as you'd expect. Synology's surveillance station also supports more advanced features like facial recognition too, which is cool. The only downside is cost. Once you've used up your free licenses, you'll then have to pay around £40 per camera to add more via a new license pack. This is a one-time fee though, so you could see it as an investment, and it works out cheaper in the long run than many smart cloud camera providers that charge you a recurring yearly fee to store really quick 20-second clips. The third cool thing you can do with your NAS is turn it into an advert blocker for all devices on your network, whether that's your phone or your computer. In other words, all your adverts will be magically blocked throughout your entire house. To do this, you can use a program like AdGuard or Pi-hole. This is installed within a Docker container on your Synology NAS, for example. And once you've installed one of these services, you can configure it and it will then be available as a network-wide ad blocker. But at this point, the service is just running inside your NAS, but all your devices, you know, your phones and your PCs are still routing straight to the internet. So you then need to go into your router and adjust it so that the DNS settings are pointing to your new DNS server on your NAS. This means that all your devices will then connect to your Synology DNS's server, and that will then block any adverts that websites or apps might try to show. This video isn't intended to be a super deep dive into every method, because otherwise the video would be 10 hours long. But I've put links down in the description that shows exactly how you can do this. The fourth thing you can do with a powerful NAS from a company like Synology or QNAP is to turn it into a virtualization environment and run, well, pretty much anything on it. I actually touched on this in the previous method, but by enabling Docker or its equivalent, you can run so many different containers or images on your NAS. This then turns your NAS from a simple file storage device into a full-blown server. The possibilities are almost unlimited, but for example, if you find that you have lots of devices and sensors around your home that collect data, you could install a database like MariaDB on your NAS and then use this as a central place for data collection and logging. Or you could decide to host a web application from your NAS and use your newly installed database for this web app. And that brings me nicely onto my fifth use for NAS, because you can install packages like web servers and also languages like PHP, Python, and Node.js. You can then actually host an entire dynamic website on your NAS and have real people access it over the internet. This is what Marius does. His entire website is hosted on his Synology NAS, which is pretty cool. Now, I probably wouldn't host mission-critical web apps from my NAS, but a smaller personal or portfolio website could be ideal. Marius' website shows you exactly how to set up the NAS as a web server, and it's a really awesome detailed guide, so I'll drop a link to that down in the description. The sixth use for NAS is ideal if, like me, you enjoy hacking into the NSA. Wait, what? Kidding. But there are many benefits to installing a VPS server on your NAS and then routing all your connections through this. It will greatly increase security for all your devices because you can ensure that everything is encrypted and your devices are all kept a bit more private too. Most good NAS makers support VPS setups by default, although I'd say the QNAP probably have the best support. They support various different VPN providers. The QNAP website runs through all you need to do to turn your NAS into a VPS server, but it's kind of similar to network-wide ad blocking approach that I mentioned earlier. Essentially, you install a VPN package on your NAS and then configure your main router so that all devices can use this. In this case, by relying on port forwarding rules in your router. Then your end devices, like your computer and your phones, can then connect as a VPN client in the normal way, for example, by installing an app on your phone. If you have lots of smart tech around your home, then the seventh cool thing you can do with your NAS is turn it into a home automation server. By using Home Assistant and things like Zigbee 2 MQTT, you can banish all your other smart home hubs like the Philips Hue Bridge and instead run everything through your NAS. You can then create quite a powerful home automation hub straight from your NAS, which is also pretty cool, and it means that you won't end up with 20 different apps on your phone. Nice. Now, this sort of got a bit more difficult recently when Synology upgraded DSM to version 7 because they banned various USB devices like some Zigbee dongles. But you can still do this, it'll just require some tinkering. I'll drop some links down in the description for this as well. If you take lots of pictures and you like the convenience of being able to see and share those photos via the cloud, then number 8 could be for you. The downside of traditional cloud-based photo apps like iCloud and Google Photos is that they are often targeted by hackers or phishing scams, leading to things like the 2014 celebrity photo leak. You can instead store all your photos within Synology Photos, for example, and then access your photos over the internet, if you choose to enable this, using things like the Synology Photos mobile app. You can also easily set up a share link for specific photos or albums and adjust the privacy settings for this quite a lot. It's also a pretty powerful solution with automatic tagging and photo organizing based on faces and metadata, allowing you to easily find photos later on. Number 9, if you have lots of media files like movies, TV shows, music, and photos, then you can store them all on your NAS and turn it into a media server, allowing all these clips to be processed and transcoded. You can then stream all your media to your devices, such as your living room TV, computer, or mobile phone. There's lots of different routes you can take here, depending on exactly what media you have and how you want to stream it. But generally speaking, both Synology and QNAP support Plex really well, while QNAP is probably better for Kodi. The main downside of using your NAS for this is that it can be really resource intensive, especially if you're frequently adding loads of new media to transcode. So a really budget NAS might struggle to perform as a media server. The final thing I wanted to cover is to go paper-free by turning your NAS into a digital document store. You can do this by firstly installing software like Paperless on Synology or PaperOffice on QNAP. Then you scan in your old-fashioned paper documents and they're processed by the digital software. This then scans all the text and a few other metadata points and allows you to easily look up these documents in the future, which is really cool. It's much easier than hunting through drawers of paper to find what you're looking for. And that covers the 10 uses for NAS that I can think about, but if you can think of anything more, then please do let me know down in the comments. It would help us all out. I should also point out that some of these methods can stretch the computational power of your NAS. For example, my 2-bay Synology NAS would struggle to process more than 5 or 6 4K cameras. Equally, I wouldn't purchase a £80 NAS and expect it to be a flawless media server. And that wraps things up. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please click the thumbs up button. This tells the YouTube algorithm that more people should see this video. Please also subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and thanks for watching.